what is this just leftover fear, I'll call it, from Friday?
There's really no fresh news or catalyst. I was watching the bond market overnight. As we know, as we've been talking about here, the bond movements have spooked these stock movements, and so that's been one of the catalysts. Now, in the bigger picture, everybody's wondering, what are the headwinds for the stock market? How far are we going to go down, and have we seen the top? Is it already in? My guess would say no, but only time will tell. Some of the things that investors are fearing right now are the Federal Reserve having to get behind the curve and raise rates four times this year. Friday's jobs report was kind of the icing on the cake there. It really brought to the forefront the inflation issue. And so that's something that's scaring a lot of investors right now. So going forward, we're going to be taking a look at that, as well as many other causes. We could see a slowdown in China, any number of things. But right now, we've seen a lot of froth build up in the equities markets, and we're simply seeing it blow off. From the traders that I'm talking to, they're still characterizing this sell-off as healthy.
Okay, I mean, that's the point here. I think people see these numbers, these big sell-offs. Is there an indication that there's any panic selling here? Because let's remember, no. The fundamentals, which are about earnings, are still really solid.
That's an excellent point. Earnings are very solid, and they should be going forward. We're looking to close out the current quarter with 15.5% EPS. That's if everything closes in line with what we've gotten so far. So that's just amazing, and there's no reason that would slow down. So like I said, valuations had gotten a little bit stretched, and we're seeing some of the froth blow off, and valuations are coming down now that the price is coming down. Mm-hmm. So we're simply getting to a new equilibrium price and a new equilibrium situation, where we have more volatility in the markets. We knew that the volatility being so low at such a record low simply was not sustainable. And we've seen big moves in the bond market and in equities this year that suggest that it's simply not over.